والأرض بعد ذلك دحاها أخرج منها ماءها ومرعاها والجبال أرساها متاعا لكم ولأنعامكم.
Daha means, in classical Arabic, he spread out or he expanded. And that's the general meaning of it. Although there are other words to mean to spread out and to expand. So the point is, what's the difference between this word and other words? A good way of understanding a word is to go to the way that the ancient Arabs use this word. How do they use it? It would give an idea of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala meant. So the ancient Arabs actually use this word to explain the action of an ostrich preparing the ground or the nest before laying their eggs. So in the environment where ostriches live, the ground is very hard. So what happens is they start using their feet and their beaks to soften the ground, to prepare the ground before laying their eggs. So let's have a look at this just for a second. You can see how the ostriches are doing this. They're softening the land to prepare for laying their eggs. So this is a very important matter, a matter of survival, obviously. So they want to take extra care with their eggs. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala actually uses this word to indicate his preparation. Preparation for us. And it's honoring for man. Now there are many aspects related to this ayah, grammatically and rhetorically, that's used. So I'm not going to get into these details. There's a lot more than why. Is because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explains what dahaha means actually. He explains it in the following ayat. Why are we interpreting it to mean this if Allah explains it? So the following ayat say, أخرج منها ماءها ومرعاها والجبال أرساها. So he extracted from it its water and its pasture, and the mountains he set firmly. Now what's interesting about this is there's no conjunction joining this ayah to what comes after it. If there was a wow, wa akhraja minha, then it would just be joined, so one after the other. He did this and this and this. But by not mentioning the wow, what this does actually is this becomes a clarifying sentence. Actually, both of these are clarifying sentences of this ayah here. So it's known as a jumla bayaniya. I actually explain this concept in my advanced courses. But the point here is that if you want to know what dahaha means, it's akhraja minha ma'aha wa mar'aha وَالْجِبَالَ أَرْسَاهَا. So as we said, daha means to prepare the earth. And this is how Allah prepared the earth for us. And he says, مَتَاعًا لَكُمْ وَلِأَنْعَامِكُمْ, as a provision for you and your livestock. So this interpretation is more in line with classical Arabic,